code white. You've likely heard those words called over a PA. In general, it means there's a violent person on hospital premises and serves as a call to action for staff and security to try to de-escalate the situation. And they're happening at an alarming rate.
This is really putting our public at risk.
Yesterday, we brought you the story of a nurse who was assaulted so brutally at Southlake Regional Health Centre in Newmarket that she remains in hospital nearly a week later. Now, most code whites aren't so heinous, but they're happening increasingly. Statistics obtained by City News through a series of Freedom of Information requests show that at St. Michael's, they've increased from 112 in 2016 to 178 in 2017. At Toronto General, they've also increased year over year. And at Brampton Civic Hospital, they've risen from a staggering 433 in 2016 to 472 in 2017, and were on pace for over 600 by the end of last year.
Over 400. That means that every single day, at least one code white is being called, if not more. And we're continuing to see those numbers increase.
Dr. Naveed Mohammed says code whites are more prevalent at Brampton Civic Hospital because staff are encouraged to sound the alarm whenever they feel there's a potential for violence.
We'd rather have our staff be proactive and do those things early than wait until the situation becomes more dangerous. So most of our code whites are situations where some de-escalation happens. Code whites are not people running around and tackling people or fighting. That's what we don't want to get to.
Mohammed says many times code whites are being sounded because of patients suffering from mental health issues.
We admit the third most mental health patients in the province. The only two organizations that admit more mental health patients than us is CAMH, which is a mental health only facility, and Homewood, which is a mental health and addictions only facility.
He adds that the Central West region, which includes Etobicoke and Brampton, has the fewest amount of psychiatrists per capita, making it difficult for patients to access care in the community.
We actually saw this government cut $330 million out of mental health funding. So again, rather than investing and making sure that those services are going to be available to our communities, this government is looking for ways to cut and create efficiencies rather than invest in those services that are so needed.
The provincial government recently committed to spending $3.8 billion in mental health care services over the next decade. Its first investment was for 50 more mental health beds. But Mohammed says much of the violence experienced in hospitals could be avoided with investment outside of its halls.
If the ministry can provide or work with us to provide more resources to the community to help our mental health patients, that would be a big step for us.
We asked the health minister's office what steps they were taking or planning on taking to help curb violence in Ontario's hospitals and best protect staff and patients. They pointed to their planned investments in mental health care services.